Good afternoon to everyone. Myself Mohandass, and I am a scientist over the National Institute of Oceanography. We mainly deal with the oceans and ocean sciences, and that is, we are one of the constituent laboratory in the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. We have three branches, and NIO Goa is the headquarters, and Mumbai, Vizag, and Cochin are the regional centers. We mainly concentrate on that is the ocean sciences. Here I am going to talk about that why we need to concentrate on oceans for the resources. So my talk mainly will be focused on the resources, what the ocean has, what we can get it from there, and some of the things which will be useful to the biotechnology applications, mainly for the human healthcare aspects. So if you look for the oceans and its richnesses, ocean constitute, everyone knows that, more than 70% of their surfaces, out of which 60% is covered of waters, and that is in that more than 2,000 meters depth, and that is. If you see that marine environment contains more than 80% of the world plant and animal species, and that is. If you see that entire planet, you can put it in the oceans, and still you can see the space of some more organisms, so that much vast oceans, and that is. More than 3 lakh flora and fauna has been found in the marine environment, and it is right now more than 10,000 compounds has been isolated from over there. If you see that in the planet, and it is the total of 36 known phyla, among 34 are present in the marine environment, and marine species are having a tremendous potential for two reasons. One is, whatever you are getting in the planet, same thing or more than that can be received from the oceans. Second thing is, the ocean is something different, and it is because, the, say for example, high saline, high pressure, high temperature. So the, because of that, the organisms or the animals present over there can produce a lot of extracellular materials called enzymes, polymers or proteins, which can be used for various applications. If you see the classes of marine resources, can be a physical resource. You can get the minerals, and already talked about so many people. Biological resources, I am going to talk about that now. Marine energy and resources, of course, some people were talking it. And non-recreative, extractive resources, transportation, recreations. Just I entered that previously for the tourism, I could get that, and some people have already talked about that. And so my talk will be mainly on move around the biological resources. If you see the some of the views of marine resources, water, and it is, ocean contains 1.457 into 10 to the power of 9 cubic kilometers of water, that is 97.52% of the world total water resources. You can imagine how much water we have it in that. If you see that salt present over that, million tons of, each cubic meter, 165 million tons of solid materials present over that, which is contains all the chemicals, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, or what else. You can get the energies by tidal currents or the wind energy, osmotic pressures, and the bioresources, as I said that, more than 3 lakh species are there, which has with the high potential of anything you look for that, you can get it from there. So marine biotechnology, if you look that, and it is, just take it from the marine living resources, either you can use it the cultures as such, or you can grow it them into the some medias, using and the various molecular techniques, you can use it for the services or the products. You see the services ecosystem functioning, and the basic research for bioremediations, removal of pollutants, and if you look for the products, and that you can get in the drugs, biofuels, food, enzymes, biopolymer, and organisms. As I said that, what else you will not get from the oceans, and anything is there, anything you look for that oceans will give you. Only thing how we are going to make use of these ocean facilities. The areas, key areas, if you look that, and it is the food is the main concerns, and people will be aware that, and it is one of the cyanobacteria, it is spirulina, has been used worldwide for the people are giving it for the brain development and other things. Energy, of course, the fire fuels now people are talking about. The oceans, and again, it is microalgaes used for the chlorella and other things they use for the fire fuels. Human health, of course, most of the drugs has been developed, and it is. And the industrial products like enzymes, again I am talking about the enzymes, polymer, biomaterials, and environmental health, of course, marine organisms can be used for the bioremediation purposes. If you see the marine microbes as a bioresources, so far so many marine microbes have been identified, and it is, but the secondary metabolites comes down, it is very recent one. Last, it is more than, it is only close to 50 years or so. If you see the drugs, it is approved drugs, it has been isolated from the oceans. 9 approved drugs were already in the market, and 12 clinical trials has been taken out, and it is. When you see that ocean resources, the microorganisms, especially the bacteria, fungus, are playing a major role to get into that health compounds of, and mainly for the pharma industries. Some of the materials which is available, already marketed for the skincare products, marine products, and the product name is called Avicine, that is used, the organisms, marine organisms, Aldromonas, and the sea coral. Like that, so many are this thing, materials has been derived from the marine organisms. You can see that, and I have given it to one side of the organisms, and what is the commercial name present over that. This indicates that, and it is, you can get a lot of skincare products from the marine organisms, and still we can also look for that. UV absorbing compounds, and it is now, the because everyone is talking about that, and the global warming and UV radiations coming from there, of course, and it, it causes the skin cancer and other things. The microsporine amino acids are known for that screening, skincare products, and it is, and marine bacteria or cyanobacteria are known for that. You can get it from the marine, and it is. Antioxidant compounds, every day, and it is, nowadays people's lives are very much of tension, and it is, so they produce a lot of free radicals, and it is, to avoid that, and antioxidants products are been there, and it is, there also you can get it from the marine resources of various fungus and bacteria, so on. Antimicrobial compounds, and again, and it is, because the, nowadays the available drugs are having it a multi-drug resistance, so that we need to go look for the new compounds which is having the drug resistance and all. So there also you can get that from the marine bacteria or fungus or whatever it is. Marine is a good source for taking the drugs. And now I come to that, close to that, what NIO is doing on that marine microbes for healthcare products, and it is, we use the bacteria, fungus, cyanobacteria and thrastocytes. One by one, some of the things I just want to say that, and it is, because already you people are in very hungry, and it is, some of the compounds and lipid peroxides can be produced from one of the isolates of our marine vibrio, and it can produce the compound phenol 2,4 dimethyl and pyrrole compound. These compounds can be used for that deterioration of membrane lipids. If you see the activity against lipids and the peroxidases, you can see that, and it is brain, and it was tested in the sheep brain and liver and lipoproteins. You can see the inhibition levels of 10% and 20% over there, and it is, this all the things I am, it has been published with the international journals. And pigmented bacteria, and it is, one of my friend was talking about the seaweeds, and it is, of course, seaweeds all can be used, and the seaweeds host also can be used, not only seaweeds, the organism associated with the seaweeds also can be used there. This is some of the bacteria associated with the seaweeds we isolated, and more than 145 species has been isolated, and some of the organisms are having it much better than the commercial antioxidant which is available in the market, and it is flutoxyhydroxyd olivine, PHD, it is the standard antioxidant. And our organisms are Pseudomonas coriensis and Pseudomonas rubidilla has been having the highest activity than the commercial compounds which is available. This is very much can be used for the commercial purposes. Again, and it is one of our organisms, and cyanobacteria, leptolingbiasis, this is cyanobacteria which can produce a mycosporin-like cinerin, and it is the compound, it is the first time report of that. See, the compound has been cinerin, and it is, it has that UV observing compound. This has been tested with the L'Oreal. That is a commercial brand of females, and a very international brand, and has been tested that it is equivalent to that, it can give that UV protections to the human beings. Silver nanoparticles, again, it is the seaweed associated bacteria. It can be produced in a lot of silver nanoparticles, which has, have that antioxidant potential about human pathogens, so many organisms, Enterobacter, Proteus, Staphylococcus, Salmonella, and so on. So even the mangrove leaf extracts also can be used for antibacterial activities, because the mangrove leaves are having the compounds like safranin, glycosides, tannin, flavonoids, phenols, alkaloids, and volatile oils. This all having the potential of inhibiting the pathogens, so this can be very well used for that. Again, the some of the bacteria which we have tested is Staphylococcus aureus, and it can be shown that it is showing it better activity against the human pathogens. We are also the expert for beta-carotene and recycling of paper, MSW decolorizer, bioremediators, and marine enzymes. If you see that, carotene productions from one of our stains and tonelilla, it can give 5.78 micrograms per liter of beta-carotene, which can be used as a food industry. and de-inking, and if you want to use the paper for recycling, in first the ink has to be removed, that so that the brightness of paper will be increased. And it is, this is one of the work, and it is Vibrio species from the marine organisms. We can very much use it for de-inking of the papers. This is filed in the international patent in US, and of course it is also published. And it is MSW declarations. Lots of distilleries are using a molasses suspend wash. It has a dark brown color, and it is, you cannot be released it in the marine environment. So we use that flavored on flavors, one of the fungus, and it can declarate that molasses pen vases. And this also the having a compound, and it's called it pensopyrene, and it is polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons that can be removed from that. So that we also tested the toxicity in the fracture water fishes, Oreochrombis mosasmicus, that also shown that very much it can be, this water can be reused for that growing the fishes, and all that also has been published. So in enzyme microbial technologies, and so many toxicities now, the tanneries and textiles, they are releasing lot of effluents from the environment, and it is, we have the organisms with us, Sivanella, and it has a good potential for decreasing or degrading that toxicity of textile and tannery waste. The same water can be used for that algal cultures, and we have tested it, and it is showing it very much the algae can be growing after the treatment of this. Again, decoloration of color removal of Congo red. This is one of our organisms isolated from the Dietsia. It is isolated from the marine sources. And the Congo red is very toxic. You cannot put it in the marine environment. So our organisms, which has been degraded the diosin, and it is giving the 4-aminothrinaphthal-1-sulfonate, which can be less toxic in comparatively, so that it can be very well put it in the environment. To conclude that, and people were working on that, mainly on that antibacterial, antibiotic activities, people also has looked for the extremophilic organisms from the deep oceans or high saline waters, which have a lot of potentials and will have very good applications for pharmaceutical side, and it is, one should look for that.